keep emotions towards them. Now here's what you missed in the text. It has been a touch to the grief.
Saint Vincent. See, when the people saw him, they talked about what he used to be. They described him by his names. Some of us miss. How many people know this to be? Who used to be lame, walking? There has to be an appreciation that he could not have done. Let me bring it to me. When you look and see what God is doing in your life, I don't know if you'd like to make a deep pause and think about the next steps. Let's not be happy. Let's not be happy. The people who said it wouldn't amount to anything. And then I stop and I say, look at God. If you ever allow God to do the mission. Now, here's where I started and here's the message. That you are out of dysfunction until you get there. So just when you think you arrive, God extends the hand out one time. And he says, come up higher. That's why heaven, in book Genesis, in book, when it reads in Genesis, when it talks about a vision of heaven, talks about the bend, like you're climbing a ladder. Don't you wish that God would just beam you up? Bam! Holy. Don't cuss no more. Don't get angry. Anybody know his brands? I might not cuss no more, but I take it. I might not say it, but it's still in my mind. I put an answer to it. I ever get my mouth slip. It's jealous. Never mind the way you act, you want to keep climbing. But what God says, you can't do this by yourself. See, there's some people who are higher than you, they must turn back. There's some points that you can be so weak that you don't know how you're going to make it. God says, that's what the church ought to gather around and protect you until you grow. My sister, my brother, if you're here today, and here's how messages go. I've been in the pew too, and you know this message was for me. You don't have to tell me. I don't need nobody to touch me, anoint me. You don't have to look at me and say, you know, but I know without a shadow of a doubt God is talking to me. It's at that moment where you got to receive the hand. This is called a pulpit for a reason. It's called a pulpit because heaven is reaching down. And he's going to pull you up to another level. He said, I want to give you life. And I want to give you another level. I want to give you life more abundantly. I don't have to beg. I don't have to part you. You know, this is where you meet me at the altar. I wouldn't wait for someone to look at you. I wouldn't wait for someone to tell you that that was for you. Won't you come? Won't you tell God that you hear his voice, that you know that this message is ministering to you in such a profound way that you cannot explain? I don't know how God knows you, how God gives the preaching the business. But God wants you to understand there's nothing happening in your life that he's unaware of. And here's what he said. Come just as you are. In other words, he said, don't try to fix yourself up. Don't try to put on a good face. Just come. I'll do the rest. I'll do the lifting. What I like about God is when God tells you to get up and he gives you the empowerment to get up, he tells you, you pick up your bed. Clean the spot where you are. Don't let nobody come by and see mess in your area. Let them wonder where they used to be. When God cleans you up, people will wonder if that's still you. They wonder if this is the same person. They're looking in the old business of what that means to you because you've been cleaned up.
I know you've really been enjoying our time, but until next week. next time, same station, same time. Let's get together and share the word one more time. God bless and enjoy your day.